There is another interesting way of seeing differentiation, and that is differentiation as slope of a line. Now, slope of a line, if you remember from your school days, represents the tan of the angle made by the line with the positive x-axis. So keeping that in mind, let us look at the same graph which we have been discussing till now. So I have chosen two points. Let us call the points AB, and the y-axis is actually I'm representing for distance covered, which I'm writing as x, and the x-axis, usually this axis is called x-axis, right? But here we are using it for time. So the coordinates of this point are x1 t1, x2 t2. Now, you know that the average rate of change is x2 minus x1 by t2 minus t1. This is your average rate of change between t1 and t2. Now let me draw a straight line passing through these two points. Okay, straight line passing through these two points. Now, if I draw a triangle here, this triangle, then you can see this side of the triangle is your this interval, which is x2 minus x1. So this interval is x2 minus x1, which we can write as delta x. And this interval is your t2 minus t1, which I can write as delta t. Now, if you observe carefully, this is what? Average rate of change between A and B, right? Or you can say between t1 and t2. And this I can also write now as tan of this angle. Think carefully. You know from your school days, the tan of this angle for this right angle triangle is opposite by adjacent, right? So tan theta. And tan theta is nothing but what? Slope. So this ratio is nothing but tan theta. And tan theta is slope of the line AB. Slope of which line? This line AB, which is a straight line passing through the two points corresponding to T1 and T2. So slope of the line AB represents nothing but average rate of change, right? Now, we want to talk about differentiation, dy by dx, and remember, or I should say in this case, dx by dt. Now, dx by dt happens when, remember, t2 becomes very close to t1. So let's see what happens to this graph when t2 becomes very close to t1. So if you observe this graph, then as I bring B closer to A, or you can say this time t2 I bring closer to t1, so that the average rate of change becomes instantaneous rate of change. You see this line joining the two points, when you bring this B closer, first becomes like this, and then when you bring it very close, those two become almost the same point, almost the same point. And therefore, when you draw this line, it touches basically just one point, because B is very, very close to A, tends to zero, right? Delta T tends to zero means what? T2 tends to T1. T2 tends to T1 means this point comes very, very close to this point. So when this second point comes very close to first point, the line joining the two points is like joining only one point. And when a line joins only one point to the graph, that line is what we call tangent, right? So this is your tangent. So when your point B comes very close to point A, your this angle theta becomes this angle, which I will call phi. And then this whole equation will become tan theta will now become phi, and your delta x by delta t will be under the limit delta t tends to 0, isn't it? Because this part means your B is very close to A. And when B is very close to A, T2 is very close to T1. And when T2 is very close to T1, delta t is close to 0. So this ratio, when you put this condition that the interval should be very small, then we call that ratio differentiation of x with respect to t. And that is nothing but tan of phi. And tan of phi is what here? slope of not a line joining two points, but slope of tangent. Slope of tangent at a given point. So if you want dx by dt at this instant, then what you do? You draw a tangent at that instant. Once you draw the tangent, measure the angle phi, then tan phi will also give you differentiation of x with respect to t, or you can say tan phi will give you dx by dt. So the average rate of change is nothing but tan theta, which is the slope of the line joining two points, because whenever you talk about average, there are two points, remember, two instants. But when you talk about differentiation or instantaneous rate of change, instantaneous, then you are talking about only one instant. So the slope of the line between two points becomes slope of tangent at a point. So try to remember these two basic things about differentiation as a slope. So just now we learned that if you want dx by dt, which means differentiation of x with respect to t at a specific time t, graphically if you want, then what you do? You draw a tangent at that point and then calculate tan phi. So tan phi, when you calculate at this moment, that will give you rate of change at that moment, dx by dt. What if I ask at this point? Can you guess? Well, at that point, if you try to draw a tangent, I hope you realize it will be parallel to x-axis. So since the tangent is parallel to your time axis actually, so here the angle made by the line with your time axis is zero, isn't it? Since this is parallel to this line, angle will be zero between parallel lines. So at that point, since your phi is zero, your angle is zero, tan zero we all know is zero. Tan zero is sine zero by cos zero. Sine zero is zero, cos zero is one. So zero by one is zero. So since tan zero is zero at this point, it means dx by dt will be zero at this point. Dx by dt is zero at this point. Can you guess what about at this point? Well, at that point also, if you draw a tangent, you can see that even at this point, your dx by dt is zero. So what you realize is, students, whenever x changes with time and x has a maximum or x has a minimum, isn't this the maximum value of x, right? Here x is maximum. You can see here x is increasing, this x value is increasing and then decreasing with increasing time. So here x value is maximum. So at this instant, when x is maximum, if you ask what is dx by dt, answer is zero. Similarly, at this instant, when x is minimum, if I ask what is dx by dt, again it is zero, because the tangent is parallel to time axis. So angle is zero. If angle is zero, tan zero will be zero. So please try to remember, whenever your x is maximum or your x is minimum, dx by dt will be zero. Now this is general. So generally, how I can say? Generally, let us imagine this is your x-axis and this is your y. Because generally this can be anything, right? This can be distance, this can be velocity, this can be displacement, this can be work done, this can be time, this can be position, like in this example. So generally we write y and x. So if your graph is like this, then at this point, when y is maximum, what we should write at this instant? Dy by dx must be equal to zero. Okay, so try to remember this concept, very useful in physics. So at maxima or minima, your derivative of y with respect to x will be zero. Now in this case, since y axis I am using as position and x axis I am using as time, I wrote dy by dx as dx by dt, right or not? There is a very simple way to understand why at the point of maximum dy by dx should be 0. Why? Like we have understood through slope, but another way to understand is from here to here you can see y value is increasing, isn't it? Right? Y value is increasing. So as long as it increases, there will be some change. Increase is also change, right? But when it reaches here, you see it has stopped increasing. Now it has to decrease. So at that point, it is like saying it has stopped increasing. So stopped increasing means in a way stopped changing. So since it is not changing, the change in y must be zero. A small change in y at that point has to be zero, right? So this is a very easy way to understand why here dy by dx is zero, because up to that point y is increasing and then it is not increasing any further, which means at that point it must have stopped increasing. So the change in y at that instant has to be zero. If change in y is zero, dy by dx has to be zero, because dy by dx represents rate of change, right? So let's see an interesting problem based on the concept of maximum and minimum, which we discussed before, right? So if y is equal to some function they have given, 10t minus 5t square. So this is function of x or t. It is function of t, remember. They are asking you find the t when your y is maximum. So if you keep changing t, obviously y will change, right? So they are asking you, for what value of t your y will be maximum. So how to solve such problems? Already if you remember, I discussed with you that if y is a function of x and there is a maximum for y, then at that point of maximum, if you draw a tangent, that tangent will be parallel to x-axis, right? And if it is parallel to x-axis, what is the slope of that tangent? Zero. So here, since slope is zero, it means dy by dx also should be zero, isn't it? So coming back to this question, here y is a function of t, not x. So if y is maximum at any t, if y is maximum for some value of t, then at that t, what should be zero? Dy by dx, no, dt. Because y is function of t, so that should be zero. So substitute y, d by dt, what is y given? 10t minus 5t square, that should be equal to zero. Now there are two terms, so you have to distribute this to first term and to second term. So this will be d by dt of first term is 10t minus second term is 5t square, that should be zero. Now, what is the rule? If there is constant into some function, you should take the constant outside. So 10 into d function by dt minus, again 5 is constant, take it outside. 5d by dt of t square, that should be 0. Right? We are just applying the rules and formula, nothing more. So 10, what is dx by dx? Dx by dx is 1. So what will be dt by dt? Obviously 1. What was dx squared by dx? 2x. So dt squared by dt will be 2t power 2 minus 1, which is obviously 1, which we don't have to write in the power. So equal to 0. So this is 10 minus 10t equal to 0. So you can take minus 10t this side and then it will become 10 equal to 10t. Therefore t equal to 10 by 10. Therefore t equal to 1. So when t is equal to 1, your dy by dt must be 0 from the solution. Therefore, at this t, your y must be maximum. Okay? So again, similar question. If y is equal to sine theta plus cos theta, find the theta for which y is maximum. This time, as you can see, y is a function of theta. So we need to find the theta where y is maximum. So we know the condition. If y is maximum for some value of theta, then dy by d theta this time should be 0. That means what? Substitute your y function, what is given? sin theta plus cos theta. So this should be 0. There are two terms, so distribute this first term, then distribute to second term. So d by d theta of sin theta plus d by d theta of cos theta. That should be 0. Differentiation of sin theta is your cos theta. And differentiation of cos theta, if you look, is minus sin theta. Please check your notes. So plus minus is minus equal to 0. So sin theta will go that side. So cos theta equal to sin theta. Then if I divide both the sides by cos theta, I will get 1 equal to sin theta by cos theta. But what is this? This is tan theta. So tan theta is equal to 1. This means theta should be 45 degrees, isn't it? So when theta is 45 degrees, that time this summation of sin theta plus cos theta, that will be maximum, right? So when y is maximum? When this happens, and that the answer is coming 45 degrees. So very interesting result, right?